I'd initially figured I'd approach this video as it handled the previous ones, as one big lecture. As I wrote out the script, however, I quickly found that it was just going to end up being far too long. While that in and of itself isn't a huge problem, considering how dense the topic is, I'll be breaking it up across multiple videos instead. Our goal is simple. We're going to introduce the concept of perspective. We're going to talk about what perspective is, not as this daunting, looming villain, but as a tool that can be used to help us achieve specific goals. But before we get to all of that, Drawabox is not a perspective course. Drawabox is a course that focuses on developing your internal, instinctual understanding of 3D space and how the things we draw exist in three dimensions, despite being made up of lines and shapes on a flat page. Perspective is one of the tools we use to achieve that, but it is important to remember that it is just that, a tool. If you are looking for a structured course that delves into all of the technical elements and maths involved in linear perspective, I'd recommend looking at Eric Olson's A Complete Guide to Perspective for Artists from our sponsor, New Masters Academy. It is very thorough and will patiently guide you through the most basic principles all the way to the most advanced techniques that can be used to create complex scenes, confident that they will line up with reality. So, boxes. Why are we so obsessed with boxes? Well, we're trying to learn to think in 3D, and a box is a perfect representation of those three dimensions. That is to say, it gives us three sets of edges that are parallel to one another in 3D space, each one perpendicular to one another, which matches the relationship of the different dimensions of space. If you've studied any 3D geometry, 3D modeling, or physics, you'll have heard these three dimensions represented as X, Y, and Z, though I find in drawing it can be easier to initially discuss them as width, height, and depth, all relative to the viewer looking out into the scene. Just so we're on the same page on that front, I'll define what I mean by each one very briefly. Width is the dimension that runs horizontally perpendicular to the viewer. So you can think of this as aligning to the line on which our own eyes sit, since they span horizontally across our face. Height is the dimension that runs vertically perpendicular to the viewer, so the line that the viewer's nose follows. And lastly, depth is the dimension that moves towards and away from us in parallel to the direction we're actually looking. I often refer to this direction as the viewer's angle of sight. While the only real difference between 3D and 2D is the presence of the depth dimension, it's a pretty big difference. It takes us from looking at some flat lines and shapes on a page, and understanding that to be all that is being represented, to viewing that piece of paper as a window that looks out onto a limitless world of depth. The goal is ultimately to take something that exists on a flat surface in two dimensions and make it create the illusion that it in fact exists in three dimensions. This act is referred to as projection, where we're taking something with a higher order of dimensions and projecting it down onto something with fewer. There are many different kinds of projection that are used to capture three-dimensional objects on a two-dimensional page, and each one is geared towards a different set of needs. Perspective projection is the one we'll be focusing on in this course, and it has one concrete goal: to reproduce human binocular vision. That is, what things tend to look like when seen with two eyes arranged in the fashion you'd find on a human face. Perspective is all about reproducing what humans see. Orthographic projection focuses just on the view of an object from one of a few possible sides. It entirely eliminates the third dimension, though this is often made up for by presenting multiple views of the object, like a side view, a top view, a front view, separately across multiple images. This is sometimes referred to as a plan view because it really helps us to understand the object as we plan to draw, model, or otherwise interact with something three-dimensional. Lastly, isometric projection attempts to capture all three dimensions at once while keeping any edges that are parallel in 3D space parallel in 2D space as well. This is very useful in certain kinds of video games, where we need to be able to have the world continue forever while using the exact same pieces or tiles to represent the world regardless of whether that section is close to us or farther away. Isometric refers to a very specific formula and uses very specific angular relationships between the x, y, and z dimensions of space, but it belongs to a more general category referred to as axonometric projection. Of course, there are other approaches to projection, but you get the point. Our focus here is on perspective projection, which is built around a single core concept, foreshortening. We'll explore that in the next video.